You're learning to dissociate. You're learning to go to a state of consciousness. You're learning to make what's the good of your body. You are in a state of learning to and exercising to work with your temporal lobes and your limbic brain to be able to have an active imagination in a world where you are not supposed to, where you are able to have a living imagination in the world where you are not supposed to, where you are able to get out of your body into the other worlds, and the inner world and the other world, in a world where you are not supposed to. And that will be in the world training programs, you see, for you as children, and therefore many of you, are the result of creating a childhood that will force you to dissociate, force you to alter your state of attention. And this is often a process of denial. And I would suggest here that many of you learn to dissociate as children, and you learn to bring in a great denial, regardless of your personality drive, to survive. You use shame, which is an anesthetic, you use guilt, you use lack of deserving, you use any of the number of other anesthetics, which are all measures and meanings to deny, use martyrdom in that particular word, to deny it, self-pity to deny. Dissociation and denial will lead to your survival, and you did it well, and we congratulate you, absolutely, we congratulate you, and at the same time, it is important to understand that those, indeed, training tools, training wheels, need to be taken off now. But not just discarding all wheels, just those wheels, those training wheels of dissociation and denial. And indeed, the other complex concept is that of objectification and differentiation. It is the idea here of that sentient where without denial, without dissociating, that you are still able to differentiate, to make separate from yourself, to make something separate from yourself, and then to be able to objectify, to see it objectively, and to work with it in that capacity. When we talked earlier in this year of wonder about moving beyond guilt and fear, the new entanglements with all things, we, in that particular sense, we talked about focusing and locating, letting your higher self, your soul, and one another triangulate where in your body your pain, or rather where in your body your fear or your guilt is located, and then to go to that, and to go inside it. Remember, you go inside it, feel the guilt, feel the guilt, feel the guilt, feel the guilt, deeper and deeper, feel the pain, or feel the hurt, or feel the hurt, or feel the fear, all the way to the depth of it. Keep going deeper and deeper until you get both the other side of it, and both the other side of it, you can turn around and look at it, to see what color it was, what shape it was, what were its geometrics, was it hard angle, soft angle, was it fuzzy, was it shiny, was it absorbing light, was it emitting light, what colors or combination of colors, how big was it this, was it that, to objectify it, you see, to differentiate, to say, there is my fear, there is my guilt, not in here, I am not fear, it is something separate to me, and although it is you, to differentiate it, to separate it, and then to objectify it, so that you can work with it. And we would suggest here to talk to success, for example, is to separate an interview, differentiate, and then to objectify success in a personified form, certainly so, to talk to the shadow aspects of self, and to personify them in that particular way, certainly so, but to differentiate, and to objectify. And that is important, as perhaps the distinction is that when you dissociate, you do that before you feel, and therefore it contributes to the denial. Whereas when you differentiate and objectify, you do it after you feel. You see, when you feel the fullness of the emotion, you go into the depth of it, into the core of it, into the very, very bottom of it, into the very powers of its very existence and nature, and then you step beyond it, and from the far side is where you differentiate and objectify. The near side of it, that's it, before any depth of feeling, before any entry, before really owning it. Central to you, that is dissociation and denial. To go through it, to move the other side of it, owning it, recognizing, acknowledging, forgiving yourself, and owning it, that is the central way to make it separate from yourself, is a process of differentiation and objectification. And that distinction, certainly so, is very important to you. That distinction is very vital to the working way, to the experiment, to the understanding of using the lessons. Active and passive, giving, receiving as active giving and an active allowing, objectifying and differentiating versus dissociation.